Good morning. Bracious. The word bracious works out as bris aish. The covenant of fire. What is the idea behind it? It is as follows. First of all, we say, Ani Chai Mazu Teira. And it says that a city which is surrounded by a wall like Yerushalayim shows on how high and powerful and great it is. That it protects from within, should not go out, whatever is not needed, and protects from the outside. When Mashiach comes, it says, Praza is Teishev Yerushalayim, that the dwellers of Yerushalayim will be spread out. As Yerushalayim will spread out, there won't be no walls. Like it says, Yerushalayim's holiness will spread out through the whole Yerushalayim, the whole world, the whole Eretz Yisrael. And the holiness of the whole Eretz Yisrael will spread out to the whole world. That's how we make a dwelling place for God here, that it should be prepared for Mashiach's coming. And then it says also, V'ayel lehem choymas eish. That God will make a wall of fire around Yerushalayim. And it won't be for any protection. It won't be for any protection of things going out or coming in. It will be for covered for his honor. There will be a great revelation of godliness when Mashiach comes. So what is this wall in Avedas Hashem? A wall in Avedas Hashem is as follows. There are the inner will of God, the inner light, there's the outside light, the outer light, which is not so powerful, and then there's also the world. So we have to make a wall between the Pnimius and Chitzonius, and the Chitzonius to outer. Every aspect needs to have a wall. There's the idea of Torah and Mitzvahs and Gashmius, material stuff. There's the idea of a neshama and nefesh bahamis, the animalistic soul. The neshama has to have a wall that should not give out to anyone more chayus, and to hold the kedusha within it, and to protect the neshama from getting from the nefesh bahamis. On the other hand, the chitzonius also needs a wall. And that is, you shouldn't indulge yourself into gashmius. When it comes to Gashmi's physical pleasures, and it has to be in a way of beloy lev velev, without a heart. You should not feel any encouragement or excitement in it. You should be lame towards it. No heart in physical pleasures at all. So that is the idea of having a wall. So the Nefesh of Bahamas does want to get more chayis. It tries to get from the person. So each and every day that we do, each and every minute or something that we do in Aveda, we give chayis to our Nefesh of Bahamas, to our animalistic soul. And it wants to get as much as it can. And Hashem wants it to be powerful. Like this we can have Bechira. To choose which way to go. Should we indulge in the physical pleasures or should we indulge in Torah? That's the whole difference. So we have to strengthen our wall, which that is Ani Chai Mazu Torah. Torah protects us. Whether to do Torah mitzvahs or to do leis asa, to refrain from doing a leis asa. A prohibited commandment. So by learning Torah, we actually know what to do and what not to do. How much to stay focused in Judaism, how much to go out into the world, how much to indulge in the world. So you need a wall there to tell us. You need a Chai Mazu Torah. That don't go into the worldly matters with an indulgement. We cannot strengthen our Nefesh Bahamas. And that is the Torah. And we see the Torah was written Eish Levan al Gabi Shechoda. Eish Shechoda. And so too with Neshama. The Neshama, the way it is above. The Torah, which is the Eish Levana, a white fire over a dark fire, black fire. When Neshama comes down into the world, it gets darkened. That's why it says, every Neshama has to go through purification before he goes to Gan Eden. Because the Neshama does see what the body sees. Even though he doesn't do Averis, but the actual sight of something causes him to have to go through purification before he goes up. So Neshama, when it comes down into the body to rectify the Nefesh HaBahamis, becomes darkened because it has to go into a dark place into our body and deal with the Nefesh HaBahamis. Go into all the garbage that the Nefesh HaBahamis got involved with. Go deep, deep. And rectify it, purify it, take away all the dirt from it. Like we know how some animals can get so dirty. So when it comes down here, it gets darkened. But towards the end, we say, V'ahavtes Hashem likecha b'chol levavcha v'chol nafshecha. B'chol levavcha with your two inclinations. Yetzer tov and yetzer hara. Until it becomes all one. And the same thing is with Torah. The words of the learning of Torah comes to purify the world. It goes into, especially Gemara, and also in Chumash, it deals with worldly matters. So it gets darkened a little bit. Eish Shechera. But the ultimate of it is, like it says, by learning Torah, you rectify the world. As says, whoever learns Hilchos Beis HaBechira, it's like building the Beis HaMikdash. Just by learning it. Bringing the sanctification of God in this world. In the Beis HaMikdash. Whoever occupies himself in the Torah of Eilah, it says, if he brought a carbon Eilah. So by doing that, we unify the Eish Chayra with the Eish Levana. And so too with the world. That we transform the world to be a proper world. Like it says, Halu es Hashem kol goyim shabechu kol ha'umim. That it should be in a way that all the goyim are praising God. Giving thanks to God. That he strengthened his kindness upon us, the Jews. That shows how the world itself is rectified. So by us spreading light, spreading Torah, we bring more light into the world. We rectify the world. And then there will really be a wall of fire in Yerushalayim for the glory of God. The sun will come out of its ozone layer. It'll be a time of the essence of God will be revealed. Which at first glance, we cannot reveal the essence of God in a time of exile. But when Mashiach comes, it will be revealed to the fullest extent. Because we dug into the dirt of the Nefesh HaBahamis and we refined it. We refined the Nefesh HaBahamis. And we learned Torah to rectify the world also. So right there and then, all the mitzvot leisa'aseh which are written in the Torah become alive. And the Nefesh HaBahamis comes weaker. And Be'ez Hashem will go to the Gula Amitis Vashlema. When then it'll be Eila Tildi Smale. It'll be higher than the time of the Adam Rishim before the Chet even. When then there was nothing there. No bad was in the world then. But even after the Chet Adam Rishim, it says by Matan Torah, Pascha Zuhamasan. And now by us rectifying ourselves, rectifying the Nefesh HaBahamis, I should be all one. And the Torah we learn will have a likus in it. Revealed godliness. And we'll have Torah Chadash Amiti Teitzei, the new dimension of Torah, when Mashiach comes. And we'll have also Ve'elem Chaymas Eish, a wall of fire. And that'll be for the honor of God alone. No limitations. But let's keep Yerushalayim safe. All areas of Yerushalayim. Keep it holy. Don't allow things to come in. Don't allow wrong things to come in. And that's how we keep Yerushalayim holy in the time of Golos. And Be'ez Hashem will come to the ultimate redemption through revelation of Rebbe Melech HaMashiach. Take it from Yad Mamash now. Long live our Master, Teacher, and Rebbe King Mashiach forever and ever. Long live our Master, Teacher, and Rebbe King Mashiach forever and ever. Long live our Master, Teacher, and Rebbe King Mashiach forever and ever.